Hello, hello, hello. This is Dr. Janice R. Love, also known as the First Lady Coach, and I equip seasoned pastors' wives and Christian women to have the clarity, the confidence, and the courage to walk boldly into the destiny for which she was chosen by being perfectly who God created her to be. Again, the top seven reasons why women are not fully living a purpose-driven life. So are you ready for the fifth reason why it's possible that you might not be fully living a purpose-driven life? All right. Once again, drum roll. Here we go. The fifth reason why you are not fully living a purpose-driven life is because you have more questions than you do answers. All right, so let's get into this. So think about when God wants us to do something. We really, as far as walking in our purpose and doing the things that He has created us to do, there's so many questions that we have, meaning we really don't have clarity on what it is we're supposed to be doing. It could be a lot of questions. Could be like, who am I supposed to be helping? Who does God want me to help? Is it God who is really talking to me, or is it me talking to me? What exactly does God want me to do? How does He want me to do it? Meaning, what we might recognize that is it seems impossible based on our situation to do it. We might also have questions about timing. When or again, will I have time to do what it is that God is asking me to do? Or again, when will it happen? When will I get those signs that I need in order to know that it's time for me to fully live a purpose-driven life? All right, so you're not the first one that has had questions. Think about it. When we have more questions than we have answers, that oftentimes keeps us stuck, right? I know that if I don't understand something, I will just stand still, right? I will just be still until I figure everything out. I don't want to jump out there and do something ahead of myself or even ahead of God. So when I don't fully understand something, I'm waiting. I have lots of questions and I'm hoping that I will get some answers. So again, you're not the only one who has been in this situation, but let me talk about a situation in the Bible where two women actually had more questions than they had answers at the time, and then how they were able to get those answers and if that helped them to fully walk in their purpose. All right, so you ready? Let's go ahead and get started with this. So remember Mary, the mother of Jesus. She was informed by the angel that she was going to have a baby. Now, we all know the story. I am definitely not going to tell the story of Mary because that's one we all know. So she had been given what seemed like an impossible task. Okay. So here's Mary who has questions about how this is going to happen. All right. So next we have Sarah, who we all know the story of Sarah as well. Knowing that God had said to Abraham that Abraham was going to be blessed to make him a great nation, that he would have a whole bunch of descendants and a whole bunch of land, and that those that blessed him would also be blessed, and those that cursed him would also be cursed. So again, we know the story of Sarah, which at her age, it seemed like an impossible task in order for her to fully live out that situation. Okay. So again, we have two women here who had questions, I'm sure had questions. Think about it. If you were a virgin, I can't even imagine identifying with Mary. But think about it, if you were a virgin and had never been with a man and you were told you were going to have a baby, you'd have questions, wouldn't you? Or if you were way up in age and had never had children, even at this age, if the Lord laid on my heart that I was supposed to have a child, I would have a whole lot of questions. I don't know about you. Anybody else would have a whole bunch of questions? All right. Okay. So here's how, if this is the reason that you have more questions than you have answers, here's what you can do in order to not let this be the reason that you are not fully living a purpose-driven life. All right, are you ready? Okay, so the very first thing we want to do in order to not be stuck because of all the questions that we have is we want to trust that God knows what he is doing. Now, in the situation with Mary, right, we know that this was part of God's plan. The angel had come to Mary and told her that she was highly favored and that she was going to give birth to a child, right? So we know that she believed the angel, okay? And she, again, once she got the explanation that she needed, she trusted God, because we know this goes on to have her to do some amazing things. In fact, celebrate who God is and clearly say that, okay, I'm your servant. Go ahead and use me. All right. So, but let's look at Sarah. She didn't quite believe that God knew what he was doing. We know by her actions that because she went ahead and made plans on her own, we know that she didn't trust that God knew what he was doing. He had made the promise to Abraham, but somehow she felt like she was not included in the promise. But guess what? She didn't ask questions of God. Let me tell you what Sarah said when she had heard that Abraham was going to be the father of many nations. Sarah says, God has not seen fit to let me have a child, sleep with my maid. Maybe through her, I can have a child. So when we don't trust that God knows what he's doing, we probably wouldn't ask any questions, would we? If we just don't believe that God knows what he's doing, then we will probably decide that we were going to do it ourselves. Okay. And that's exactly what Sarah did. But so that's the very first thing that we want to do if we have more questions than we have answers. All right. Let me get this together here so this all makes sense. Okay. First thing is we want to trust God. Okay. Secondly, the thing that we want to do is we want to go ahead and ask the questions. If we don't understand something, if things don't make sense to us, isn't the proper thing to do is to ask the question? Now, Sarah didn't do this, but we know that Mary did. As soon as the angel told her, Mary, you're blessed and highly favored, and you're going to give birth to a child, we know that Mary had a question. Her question was, but how? I've never been with a man. And she asked the question. And because she asked the question, she got an answer right away from the angel. The angel went ahead and explained everything to her. And because he explained everything to her, Mary was able to say, yes, I see it all now. I'm the Lord's maid, ready to serve. Let it be with me just as you say. So secondly, when we go ahead and ask the question, God is faithful. He could give us an answer, right? If you have ever read Jeremiah 33:3, it says, call to me and I will answer you. And I will tell you great and hidden things that you have not known. So when you have questions about what it is that God wants you to do, simply ask the question, right? I heard a saying once that 100% of the prayers we don't pray will not get answered. So think about it. 100% of the questions you don't ask will not get answered. So because Sarah didn't ask the question, she didn't get an answer. And so she decided she was going to take it upon herself. All right. Is this making sense, everybody? Mary asked the question and she got the answer that she was supposed to get. So the very third thing that you can do if you have more questions than you have answers is to connect with someone who can recognize God's action in your life. Now, we know that what happened with Mary, as soon as the angel explained the situation to her, that she was going to have a child and how the Holy Spirit was going to come upon her, and he laid it all out for her, then we know that the very first thing she did was she got up, she packed up her stuff, and she went to visit her cousin Elizabeth. Some people say it's her aunt. I'm not going to get caught up in that. But we know the very first thing she did was she showed up at Elizabeth's house. And we know that as soon as she got to Elizabeth's house, everything was confirmed to her for her, because the baby in Elizabeth's womb jumped for joy. And she said, why would the mother of my Lord come see me? So Elizabeth confirmed things for her. Elizabeth confirmed what God was doing in her life. Elizabeth was also there as a supporter and an encourager. Remember, reason number one why we might not be fully living a purpose-driven life is because we don't feel like we have the support and encouragement. So when we have more questions than we have answers, then again, we need to connect with someone who can recognize God's action in your life. And God will send that person to you. And again, I just have to remind you that, you know, with this God resume boot camp that's coming up, remind me to tell you a little bit more about that. Then you will be in a position where you'll be able to see God's actions in your life. So you will have that support and encouragement that you're looking for, so that you can ask the question and again, connect with someone who has seen God working in your life once we go through the God resume. All right. So once again, if you have more questions than you have answers, let me tell you a few things here. What questions do you have? What questions do you have about what God is doing in your life? Is it a what, who, how, why, or when question? Ask the question. If you are out there stuck because you do not have answers, simply ask the question. Also, trust that God knows what he's doing. If whatever he says to you seems impossible, or whatever you discover seems impossible, please trust that God knows what he's doing. Then finally, connect with someone who can see God at work in your life. Just like Mary had Elizabeth, God will send you the right person. So once again, if the reason why you are not fully living a purpose-driven life is because you have more questions than answers, then it's time for you to get some answers. So I am inviting you once again to join me for our God Resume Bootcamp. Now, if you don't know what a God Resume is, we talked about this last night in session number four, Sunday night in session number four. So if you don't know about that, go back and watch session number four. But we have coming very soon a 5-day God Resume Bootcamp. Registration is going to open very soon. In fact, I might release the details like tomorrow about when this is going to start and when you can go ahead and get registered. And guess what? Guess what? It is totally free. So don't miss out on this opportunity to get more answers. All right. So that is how we will deal with that reason of having more questions and answers, so that it cannot be the thing that stops us from living that purpose-driven life. All right. So what questions do we have out here? Let me get back to a picture here so we can see me. What questions do we have out here? Lots of comments going on. Yes, yes. God doesn't mind our questions. Whoever said that, thank you for sharing. God does not mind our questions. Mary still had questions, but she didn't doubt, right? She asked the question. That's the part I love the most. She had the nerve, the courage to go ahead and ask the question. And so we have to do that too, because, you know, all we can get is a no, but again, if we don't ask, we won't know something. It's just like in our everyday lives. If we don't ask the question, we'll never get an answer. We'll be out there like Sarah trying to figure it out by ourselves, right? Because we don't have the answers. All right. So yes, she didn't doubt. Oh, thanks. Yes, Jeremiah 33:3. Thank you for whoever posted that. And God does not mind our questions. He knows what he's doing. You know, so many times I used to ask, God, you sure you know what you're doing? You know, especially when I married my husband, I had some questions, right? You sure you know what you're doing, Lord? Anyway, lots of questions can mean a lack of clarity. But again, if we don't ask those questions, then we sometimes cannot get that clarity. Yes. So make sure that you stay tuned for the information on the God resume. Anyway, I'm not going to stay out here much longer. Thank you all for joining me on tonight. Now, I will be back on Thursday night for session number 6. And then the final session will be session number 7, followed up by the God Resume Bootcamp, which is going to be exciting. And again, it's free. I want you to be a part of this because you're going to get so much information. And again, if you do not know what a God Resume is, then go back and watch session from Sunday night. All right. Okay, I'm out of here. You have a wonderful evening. Once again, I am Dr. Janice R. Love, also known as the First Lady Coach.